Thank you so much, David. Well, just hours ago, a judge decided a man accused of kidnapping, beating, and raping a woman will stay in jail for now.
Well, here's video of Ricky Franklin entering court today. That judge decided there was enough evidence against Franklin for that case to go to a grand jury. 16 WAPT's Catherine Kite was there.
What would you like to tell us?
The judge denied Ricky Franklin's request for a lower bond to be set on Thursday after hearing testimony from an investigator about what happened inside Franklin's home. Franklin is charged with kidnapping, rape, and aggravated assault that allegedly happened in November. Investigator Greg Lewis with the Hinds County Sheriff's Department testified that blood was found on the furniture, carpet, and walls at Franklin's home. Lewis says a family member called police to Franklin's home. When they got to his house, Lewis testified police found a naked woman who was severely beaten and was screaming, "Please help me."
Okay, at the hospital, she gave a statement to investigators that Mr. Franklin choked her, grabbed her windpipe, and in a statement that she gave later actually said it felt like she was trying to pull her windpipe out, but he beat her severely.
What do you say about the bruises left on her body?
I think that something happened and it escalated. Now, whether it rises to the level of aggravated assault or not is something else entirely.
Investigator Lewis also said they got several pieces of evidence from Franklin's home, including a used condom, liquor bottles, a purse, and blood-stained pieces of furniture. Another key piece of evidence is the skin found underneath the victim's nails. Investigators are still waiting for that evidence to come back from the crime lab. Reporting from the Hinds County Courthouse, Catherine Kite, 16 WAPT News.
Well, Hinds County District Attorney says this crime is very similar to 10 unsolved murders, and it's possible Franklin could be linked to those crimes. Right now, the DA's office is only focusing on this most recent case. It is expected to go to the Hinds County Grand Jury next week.